Hello everybody, look at here. Now we will discuss the adjoint and the inverse of a matrix. Adjoint and inverse of a matrix. So the adjoint of a square matrix, any square matrix is there, Aij n into n means square matrix, number of rows and columns are equal, is defined as the transpose of the matrix, this one, where Aij, this Aij is the cofactor of the elements of Aij. Adjoint of a matrix is denoted by this one. So matrix, this adjoint is denoted by this. Suppose A is a matrix is there, the elements are A11, A12, A13. So you are supposed to write down first of all the cofactor of these elements. Cofactor of this A11, cofactor of 12. So let the cofactors are coming A, capital A11, capital A12 is there. And if we take the transpose of this one, if we take the transpose of this, then you will get the adjoint of this matrix A. So one first case I am taking, like the 2x2 matrix is there, then how can you write the adjoint of this one? So first of all, you are supposed to write down the cofactor of this one. So for the A11, you will write the cofactor. So first row and first column, that is minus 1 is equal to 1 plus 1 will be will do. So first row, first column element, so this is 4, you will get 4. You write the cofactor for this 1, 2. First row, second column will be deleted, but this is minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 1 plus 2. So this is 1. So minus 1 raised to power 3 means minus 1 into 1. So you will get minus 1 is here. Similarly for this A21. So minus 1 raised to power 2 plus 1. Second row, first column is 3. So this is again you will get minus 3. For A22 is equal to, you will get second row, second column, minus 1 is about 2 plus 2, and this is 2, so you will get 2 is there. So this cofactors are, if you write the cofactors of this one, what you will get, that is 4 minus 1 minus 3 and 2. And if we take the transpose of this one, that you will get the adjoint A. So that will be equal to what? Adjoint A will be equal to this transpose of this one. So you will get 4 minus 1 minus 3 and 2. So 4 minus 3 minus 1 and 2 is the transpose of this one. But directly also you can do in case of the 2x2 matrix is there. What exactly just see now? What we are going to do? We are going to interchange these diagonal leading diagonal elements. Just see, we interchange, and here we change the sign. Here we will change the sign. This is the shortcut is there. You must change the sign is here, and here you must interchange the digits only, interchange. So directly you can also write the adjoint of any 2x2 matrix. Have a look. Yes, few more concept is here only. First is, if A be any square matrix of order n, then A into adjoint A will be equal to, adjoint A into A is equal to determinant of A into the identity matrix is there only, where A is the identity matrix. Second is, there A square matrix A said to be the singular if the determinant of any matrix is 0. If the determinant of any matrix comes equal to 0, then agar 0 aata hai, you can say that is the singular matrix. But if your determinant is not equal to 0, then that matrix is known as a non-singular. Oh, non-singular matrix. So, if the determinant A is not equal to 0. Fourth, A and B are the non-singular matrix. Means, A, the determinant of A, 0 nahi hai. Determinant of B is also not equal to 0. Of the same order, then A into B and B into R also will be the non-singular matrices of the same order. Like, determinant of A into B you will take equal to determinant of A into determinant of B is there. These are the properties. Now A into adjoint A is equal to determinant of A raised to power n. N means the order is there. The n by n is this order. If A determinant is not equal to 0, then adjoint A is equal to determinant A raised to power n minus 1. And this is the most important point here only. A square matrix is invertible. Invertible means you can take the, that is the inverse is there. A square matrix is invertible if and only A is a non-singular matrix. If the non-singular matrix is there only, then only you can find out the inverse. Agar non-singular matrix means, agar determinant A not equal to 0 hai, you can find out the A inverse of that matrix. इनवर्स ऑफ दैट मैट्रिक्स इज इक्वल टू क्या होता है, एडजॉइंट ए ओवर डिटरमिनेंट ए. दिस डिटरमिनेंट ए शुड नॉट बी नॉन सिंगुलर, होना चाहिए, इट शुड नॉट बी इक्वल टू जीरो. एंड ए इंटू ए इनवर्स इज इक्वल टू ए इनवर्स इंटू ए. इफ यू आर डूइंग ए इंटू ए इनवर्स और ए इनवर्स इंटू ए यू आर डूइंग, दैट विल कम इक्वल टू द आइडेंटिटी मैट्रिक्स इज देयर. सो दीज आर द प्रॉपर्टीज. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ इन केस ऑफ द इनवर्स. हैव अ लुक. Now, few more concept is there in case of the invertible matrix, means the inverse of a matrix is there. Then, A inverse, you are taking the inverse of matrix A, then again you are going to take the inverse of that one, you will get the matrix itself. Similarly, if you take the A transpose first, then the inverse, or if you take A inverse first, then the transpose will also be the equal. A inverse is also symmetric, and every skew symmetric matrix of order, odd order, if the order is odd, then will be the singular. A, B, A into B, then inverse you are taking, that will be equal to the B inverse into A inverse is there. And similarly, adjoint A into B you are taking, that will be equal to the adjoint B into adjoint A. Means you can take the, you can do the product first, then you can take the adjoint, or if you take the adjoint, then you are going to product will be the equal, equal over. Adjoint A transpose aap lete hain, ya A transpose का adjoint लेते हैं, that will also be the equal is there. So these are the properties in case of the invertible. Invertible matrix means the inverse we are going to discuss. Inverse is there, you know, inverse. Have a look. Yes, now the question we are taking, you have to find the inverse of this matrix. This matrix is given. We are supposed to find out the inverse of this one. So let's suppose A is equal to this one. You have to find out the determinant first, because the inverse of any matrix exists if and only if it is a non-singular. Means the this determinant should not be equal to zero. So you have to find out the determinant of this one. For this one, direct I'm doing 1 into 1 plus 3 minus minus 1, and this will be 2 minus plus 3 plus 1 2 minus 1. So this is equal to 4 plus 5 plus 1, that is equal to 10, which is not equal to 0. It means it is a non-singular matrix, because the determinant of A is not equal to 0. So therefore you can say A inverse exists. And if A inverse exists, it means you are supposed to find out the adjoint A first. How can you find out the adjoint? Adjoint A kaise nikalenge hum in sabhi ke? You have to find out the cofactor first. Cofactor nikaliye. Iske liye main C11. So, minus 1 is to power direct. I am doing 2. So, this will be 1 minus 3, 1, 1. So, this is 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. C12 minus 1 is to power 3. First, second, 2 minus 3, 1, 1. So, this is minus 1 into 2 plus 3. You will get minus 5. C13, that is minus 1 raised to power 4. This one, so 2, 1, 1, 1. So that is 1 into 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. Similarly, we have to find out the C21, minus 1 raised to power 3. Second row, first column. Second row, first column, so you will get minus 1, 1, 1, 1. So this is equal to minus 1 into minus 1, minus 1. So you will get plus 2. C22, that is minus 1 is to power 4, second, and this one 1 1 1. So this is equal to will be the 0. And C23, that is minus 1 is to power 5. This first row, third row, and first column. So minus 1 1 1 minus 3. So here you will get this is minus and 3 minus 1. So this is equal to minus 2. Now similarly, we have to find out the for this one. C31, that is third row and this one. So you will get minus 1 is to power 4. So minus 1, 1, 1 minus 3. So here you will get 3 minus 1, that is 2. C32, direct you can do that. Minus 1 is to power 5. This third row, second column, 1, 1, 2, 3. 1, 1, 2 minus 3. So this is minus and minus 3 minus 5 is equal to 5. C 3 3, that is minus 1 is to 6. Third row, third column, so 1 minus 1 2 1, so you will get here is the 1 plus 2, that is equal to 3. So finally the adjoint of this one, I am going to write this one, I am going to rub it this. So adjoint of A is, already we know that the transpose of this matrix which you are getting the cofactor. So aapko cofactor kya mila, 4 minus 5 1, then 2 0 minus 2, then 2 5 3, this is there only. 4 minus 1, 5, let me check. 4 minus 5 1, 2 0 minus 2, 2 5 3, yes. So this is your, so adjoint A you are going to look at here. So adjoint A is always equal to the transpose of the cofactors. These are the cofactors are there. So you will get equal to, this is equal to, you will get, you are supposed to transpose this one, that you will get the adjoint. So this is equal to 4 minus 5 1 2 0 minus 2 2 5 3. This is your adjoint A. But we want to find out the A inverse. So A inverse is equal to adjoint A over determinant of A. So you can write down here. So here you can write down. But A inverse is equal to adjoint A over determinant A. So this is, here you can write down. Determinant is 10. So direct I am going to write 1 over 10. And you can write down this is 4, 2, 2. Minus 5, this is your 4, 2, 2, and this is, it's all right, yes, 4, 2, 2, minus 5, 0, 5, 1, minus 2, and 3, and this is your, the A inverse, we can check the answer also, 4, let me check the answer is 4, 2, 2, minus 5, 0, 5, 1, minus 2, 3, divided by 1, 10 is there only. So this is your, the inverse of this matrix is there. So if any matrix is there, you can find out the inverse of that. Kya karna hai? Pehle adjoint A nikalo. Adjoint A kaise niklega? You have to find out the cofactor for every this one, for the elements, and take the transpose. Uska transpose lo, you will get the adjoint A, and that is divided by the, this determinant. You can find out A inverse. A inverse is exist only in case, अगर ये नॉन सिंगुलर है, मीन्स मॉड्यूलर डिटरमिनेंट शुड नॉट बी इक्वल टू जीरो. हैव अ लुक.